Donald Trump, Malcolm Forbes, Merv Griffin, they're among the 1% of Americans who control 34% of our nation's wealth.
Some people feel guilty about having a buck. I don't feel guilty about it. I feel very grateful.
Tonight, does America's ultra-rich have too much? Then striptease legend Blaze Starr bared her soul and more to Louisiana Governor Earl Long. And now she says JFK caught her act too. And shh, don't tell Richard. We'll look at the women he's loved and the death wishes he's dared to take, all to celebrate his 40th birthday.
JR, eat your heart out.
Hi, everybody. I'm Jan Yanehiro, and today we're celebrating Richard's birthday, 40, the big 4-0. Happy birthday.
I kind of prefer to think of it as my second annual 39th birthday, but thanks just the same.
We brought you here to this Porsche Ferrari dealership in San Francisco for a few surprises today.
A pink slip, maybe?
You gotta wait, but let me ask you this question, Rich. Feel pretty rich in this $175,000 Ferrari?
That's just the insurance. Jan, I feel like a billionaire.
You may feel like a billionaire, but here are a few men who feel that way every day.
I don't think it's a question of the money, really, because we have more than we ever can use. But it is just the challenge of it. We enjoy what we're doing.
Won't you give me a break? Somebody give me a break now!
If a successful businessman earning $100,000 a year can live comfortably, Donald and Ivana Trump have enough to live as comfortably for 100 million years.
Some people feel guilty about having a buck. I don't feel guilty about it. I feel very grateful.
Billionaire Malcolm Forbes can certainly afford such flights of fancy as a personal fleet of hot air balloons. He and the 399 other richest men in America have more money combined than the collective commercial savings accounts of every other American in this country.
I think people could say you're nuts if you don't enjoy living a little.
But do they live it up, really? Are flamboyant figures like Donald Trump, Malcolm Forbes, and billionaire talk show host turned hotel baron Merv Griffin really typical of the 1% of Americans who control a startling 34% of the nation's wealth?
I don't know. I know some pretty dull people that are very rich.
Not according to the ultra-rich themselves. As told to Megatrend observer Vance Packard in his latest mega volume, the ultra-rich, how much is too much?
They're not something to be envied, and they don't know what to do with the money themselves, except act foolish with it, like Mr. Trump does.
Packard interviewed 30 centimillionaires with an average net worth of $330 million. The results say the rich who act rich are in the minority. You're just as likely to meet a billionaire at the Burger King or at the movies as at the opera house or polo field.
They watch television, and they watch the same shows we watch. They watch movies, and you talk to them, and they trade ideas on the good movies they've seen lately. They go to neighborhood movies and things like that.
And while the Trumps may prefer 110-room mansions, Packard says the more typical centimillionaire lives modestly, relatively speaking.
I talked to the people who were a half a billion dollars who were living in houses that were less than 500,000.
Psychiatrists could have a field day trying to unravel the reason the rich hoard enough wealth for 1,000 lifetimes. But Packard says no centimillionaire could live on a scale equal to their wealth, so most don't even try. They could give on a scale equal to their wealth, but again, Packard says, most don't even try.
And if they're thinking of giving something to charity, they're giving, they think they're great and they give 100,000 bucks. That's just equivalent to 10 bucks for us.
When Bill Cosby, who makes around $65 million a year, donates $1.3 million to black colleges, that's a fair donation. Percentage-wise, that's a $1,000 donation from you or me. But Edwin Whitehead is Vance Packard's idea of a true philanthropist. He's given away half his $200 million so far to support basic cellular research that may one day lead to a cure for cancer.
I divide the world in givers and takers. There are takers and givers, and I want to be a giver, and this is giving. And it really is something that's worth doing and very important.
He is one of the few that is being really philanthropic and giving away over $100 million worth of his wealth while he's alive. Most of these people don't want to give away until at least they're dead and let someone else think about it.
Packard's prognosis, the wealthy should follow Edwin Whitehead's lead and give for themselves as well as us peons. The wealthy have only been this wealthy once before in this century. That was in 1929, just before the stock market crashed. So come on, ultra-rich, let's spread the dough around a little. It's like Merv says.
What does it matter? 100 years from now, who's gonna know?
Legendary stripper Blaze Starr bears all next.
Hey, Richard, congratulations. Boy, oh boy, number 40, the big one. You're turning old. That's cool. And congratulations for that. Not a lot of guys get to be old. Like, do you remember when you first came to town? What was that, about 9 years ago? I just have all these memories of, I don't know, it was like, what do I keep picturing more hair. It's not important. Is it true you went to hit on your wife last night and she called the police? They busted you for assault with a dead weapon? I'm only kidding. Did you sign a movie contract with 19th Century Fox? How old is he? Well, no, he's so old. Look at the bright side about turning 40, Rich. Okay, you got me there. There isn't one. But, hey, and my condolences to Cheryl. And let me just say in closing, seriously, man, you're not getting older. You're getting, you know, much older. Happy birthday.
I was all set to come and pick him up and take him for a ride in this thing, but
forget
it.
Now, Rich, since this is your 40th birthday, you probably expected some female person to jump out of a cake.
Yes.
But I veto that idea, okay?
No.
But the guys in the office insisted that we should have some femme fatale for your birthday.
Yes.
So we reached a compromise. From New Orleans, a story for you on Blaze Starr.
Hell, I'm a Blaze Starr!
When it comes to the fine art of burlesque, no one is more celebrated than Blaze Starr, who for over 30 years was queen of the block.
The men that I did my show for, they just seemed to enjoy it, and they never tried to grab at me or pinch me or touch me. Sometimes I'd feel a little naughty, and besides, the guys are like 20 and 30 feet away from you. So I discovered it would get a lot of screaming and yelling. So a few times I snapped the G-string.
In 1989, Blaze's story goes Hollywood. A new film loosely based on her autobiography will include scenes of her poverty-ridden childhood, her rise to fame as a stripper, and her torrid love affairs.
I'm from West Virginia, right in the heart of the coal fields, Appalachia. I used to wash for people on a rub board for $1 a day. Then it'd take a week to get your knuckles straightened out.
Born as Fanny Bell Fleming, Starr knew early in life that her greatest natural resource was her body. At 14, she looked like a woman. At 16, she was supporting herself as a stripper on the block.
I felt much older, really. Today, a 16 is very young, but where I come from, everybody gets married at 14 or 15, or you're an old maid. So when I discovered I could really, if I become a burlesque star, I could make $3,000 or $4,000 a week, well, I thought I was a millionaire.
People came from all over to see Blaze's show, including some of the most rich and powerful men in the country.
Oh, I love my men, but I would choose one I wanted to date, and I would stick with that one. My romances usually last about 3 years, tops, except I married once. That lasted 12 years.
Her most sensational affair was with the late governor of Louisiana, Earl K. Long, and it was at one of her shows that, she claims, he introduced her to a prominent political figure of the 1960s, with whom she had a scandalous affair.
He was great, fast and great. Well, he was going to be president. I guess he had to be in a hurry.
When Blaze's story hits the big screen, it'll be in grand style. Paul Newman will star as Earl Long, the fiery politician who loved the good times, and Blaze would like to see Kim Basinger as Blaze. Today at 56, Blaze collects gems, sells jewelry, and looks back on a raucous life that shook up the morals of many towns. What would she do differently?
Not a thing. Perfect. I would just do a lot more of it and try a lot harder and seduce a lot more men than I did.
Up next, Richard's death wishes and his sweetest dreams.
JR, eat your heart out.
Oh, Rich, hi, yeah. I got the list you gave me. I know you're real busy with your 40th birthday and you haven't had time to do any of your errands, so I got everything. Let's check it here. Your panty shield liners, corns, the feet must be going, Metamucil, try to get it regular, Rich. Some Geritol, beef up a bit, arthritis rub, Doan's pills. Denture cream, $1 million smile, we know why. Oh, Rich, hemorrhoid ointment, that's why you haven't been standing up straight lately. Maalox, little antacid. Rich, I know you're getting older, but for you, just getting up in the morning looks like a medical emergency. Try to keep it together, and happy birthday, big boy.
Hey, getting up in the morning is a career move for me.
Well, to continue your 40th birthday celebration, Rich.
There's more?
We have a few video birthday surprises. A look back at your younger years. Now, since you've joined Evening Magazine, goodness, some 10 years ago, you know, back then you had hair. Not long, not short, not a whole lot.
At least
you had hair. And through the stresses and strains of the job, I guess, that we've noticed you've been thinning.
It's turned gray, too, as you can probably tell.
So, to compensate for the growing lack of, you've tried different looks through the years. Here are now some examples.
Richard Hart, my new co-host. Yay!
First day on the job here. You've got hair. Look. Now you try the Santa look. Most hair you've ever had.
Dana actually is a
look
college
at this,
professor.
A fairly hairy Charles Corolls.
And a historian and more.
Okay, I've got here, the guy you're talking to has more hair on his chin than you do on your head.
Still find the plane.
That was sensational.
The wet look. The really wet look.
And of course,
Rich,
there are always
where
beach
did
sports.
You put the sunblock? And the 60s beehive look. Ooh.
One day when some of the brightest.
And then you went moonlighting as Bruce Willis.
Party.
It's true. You tried a new cream on the top of your head, didn't work.
At this rate, it won't be long
and
before you.
Finally,
can
these two heads of hair are better than one.
Well.
Yes, it's thinning, but it's not gone yet.
At least I'll never have to worry about acne again.
All right, Rich. Now, on Evening Magazine.
There's more?
Yes. You've interviewed some beautiful, sensual women.
Absolutely.
You've enjoyed these.
And I remember both of them very well.
And you've enjoyed these interviews. You've always had a keen appreciation for the opposite sex.
Absolutely.
For women. Oh, heck, let's face it.
You know me.
Rich, you're in lust.
Shall we lay down and do this interview?
JR, eat your heart out.
It's very hard to keep your eyes on the ball.
What? Is that?
Okay, so I'm having a good time. As a matter of fact, I can see living here at the Via Vera pool.
Which is about the way I feel.
Rich, even though you're 40, you are still a daredevil. I mean, danger is the name of your game. On assignments...
There's more?
On a lot of assignments, we know you've tested your fate, your destiny.
I was lucky to make it this far.
Let's face it, Rich, ever since you've joined our show, we've been trying to have you killed. Nothing personal, but it makes for good TV.
See, I already suspected that.
You know, I just had this funny thought. We're going to jump off this bridge on a bungee cord.
Don't be ridiculous.
No, not her!
Good luck and ride 'em, cowboy. No talk is cheap.
Now, you're laying down, you're doing everything, everything that I told you not to do.
Come here.
Come here, come here, come here. Come here. Come here. Come here.
Okay. Is it in my mouth?
Yeah, now put him in, put him in. Get your head, get the head between your teeth and put it right in and crush him, eat him, chew him, get him in the back and that's it. And oh, that's beautiful, isn't it?
I hope you got a piece of the rock.
I've never worked with an upside down camera.
Whoa.
Scared the living hell out of me.
You're bad.
That guy is out of his mind. He's absolutely out of his mind. He's nuts.
Well, stay with us because the big surprise is yet to come.
There's more?
Look at this showroom filled with beautiful cars. Richard, one of these could be yours. Next.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
All right, what's a big 40th birthday celebration without a big present?
That's what I say.
And Rich, you've been on the show 10 years. You've worked long and hard. And I got to tell
right.
You know, our producer, Lou Worth, and the station really appreciates all the hard work you've gone through for our show.
I certainly hope so.
Yeah, and they wanted us to be sure that you got something you really wanted for your big 40th birthday. And so they said, hey, get him whatever he wants. Now, let me ask you a question. Of all the sports cars in the world.
Oh, I thought you were gonna say Jamie Lee Curtis.
What is the one sports car you've always dreamed of owning, of having for your very own?
You know me, Jan. Lamborghini.
Of course. Okay, now close your eyes.
No.
Yes.
No.
Close your eyes.
Okay.
Wish real hard. Okay? Wish real hard. Okay, guys.
I hear a
roll
car
it
starting
in. Now don't scratch it. Don't scratch it. Bring it in slow. Slow.
Okay.
Slow.
I hear a car starting.
Slow.
Up.
Come on. Come on.
Doesn't sound like a Lamborghini.
Come on. Okay. Open your eyes, Richard.
Congratulations.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Ta-da.
Thank you. Gosh. It's what I've always wanted.
It's what you always wanted.
Now all I need is a cat to terrorize.
It is.
Vroom, vroom.
Thank you, Jan. You don't know how much this means to me. You really don't.
I can just guess. And since it's your birthday, you know, you want to enjoy your gift. We want you to have the next few days off.
You mean I don't have to come to work tomorrow?
No, or Friday. Oh. Because Thursday and Friday, we are preempted by the NCAA basketball, and we want you to have a great weekend.
I think I'll just take this to Mexico.
And join us next week at Evening Magazine.
Gene Hackman, Tom Hanks, Glenn Close. Every year, Hollywood's brightest stars vie for the coveted Oscar, but just how far are they willing to go? Then this grandmother went undercover to expose a drug lord who was killing her family with the speed drug crank. And Ronald Reagan, Ollie North. Their talk doesn't come cheap these days. But are big buck speech givers doling out words of wisdom or merely scamming for money?
Happy birthday, Richard!
Thank you, guys.
Good night, everybody. Cut the cake, Rich.
Cut that thing out.
Travel the range through U.S. Air with convenient hourly nonstops between the Bay Area and all five Los Angeles area airports. U.S. Air, the airline that gets you out and back the same day.
I need to do this in the car, but... Okay. There's one piece. Two piece. Scoop that up there.
Now, you probably thought to yourself, wow, what could be more dangerous or crazy than that?
Look. The treasured rubber fish.
Outer space, Pluto, maybe even Neptune. What's your problem, fun?
That scream just bought me another 10 seconds. I love you.
Okay, take three. I thought you were gonna start.
You want me to start? How should I start it now?
Oh, let me start it.
You start it then.
No, I think it's really better if you start it.
You want me to start it?